Hi, I'm Arjun Kapoor.
Hi, I'm Kumar Gupta.
And you're watching us on PeepingMoon.com. When we talk about Raj sir's films, I think the first one that will always come to my mind was No One Killed Jessica. It takes a courageous man to take a case at that point of time. This we're talking about many years back. It's very easy today, our audience, B, the censor board, C, the political scenarios. Today, there are a lot of things that have a freedom of speech. At that point of time, to be so daring and to tell the story as honestly as he did, I think it was a trend-setting film that I feel will always remain relevant because of the case that happened.
No, of course, with the protagonist. The shocking part of what has happened, the tragedy, it reminds you of how this evil man could be. But what motivated me to make this film was the incident of these five unlikely men going and catching India's most wanted terrorist without firing a single bullet, contributing their own money and their emotional journey to it. That's what motivated me.
I mean, this is. I would say this is a very real take. I mean, if you look at films like Munich or Zero Dark Thirty, this film is more in that realm where it's not about the typical espionage, but it's about the emotional state that the characters are. Espionage, if you speak about, I grew up. I used to love Spy Game. I thought that was such a cool film at that point in time. Brad Pitt and Robert Redford. There was Enemy of the State was also about how our government can be an enemy in itself. So there were quite a few films, Tony Scott films, Ridley Scott films. There used to be a tonality in these espionage films. In the recent past, I would say Argo, Sicario. There's espionage, but there's action, there's human element, etc. So I'm a film fanatic. So for me, every film that I consume has something that I take back from it. Yeah, I guess this is a genre which has unique elements, but in our film we've gone with a realistic tone. But I still appreciate even the slightly more glorified ones and the slightly more entertaining, even for that matter, the Mission Impossible series. The point is it still deals with the same circumstances, just the treatment and the visual palette is different.
No, of course there is patriotism, but patriotism in the line of the duty, in the work and the space that they come from. And basic emotion is of these people catching, without thinking anything, their safety and security, and going and catching this terrorist. So that is the basic emotion, and how these unlikely men, when you look at these people, they are regular people. They are people who might be next door neighbor. They don't. It won't appear. The general impression, as we were talking about spy films, the general impression that is there, which has been carried forward from the films that we have seen or things that we have heard, that these people, the intelligence people or the agent, they will always stand out, they will always carry gun, they will be somebody who will come in and you will notice them. But it is very unlike that, it is completely opposite that. So that's what was interesting, that's what was human about this, the reality of it, the humanness of it. Was something which gave me inspired me to write it and tell this story.
I know in the film the phone is very important because a lot of conversations of mine happen with my boss on the phone, but the film was not locked on the phone actually. I called Raj sir, to make it slightly more dramatic and cinematic, let me not make it so simplified, it would be boring. I called him up after I saw the trailer of Rain, because we go back from my Ishak Zadeh days when he had liked Ishak Zadeh, and I wanted to work with him. So I called him, I said, I'm so happy, I loved Rain, the trailer looks superb. So he said, tu kya kar raha hai? I said, kuch nahi, ghar pe hu. I was in Abu Dhabi. I said, I'm in Abu Dhabi for a family wedding. He said, okay, I'm sending you a script, whenever you get a chance, read it and we'll talk. So for me, I felt that I should call more directors, they give me scripts when I call them up. He sent me the script, this was 2 in the afternoon. And I called him back at 5 p.m. I said, I'm doing it. So it actually happened because I made that call. I think I maybe popped up. I was subconsciously in his head, but he took that chance because he heard my voice, or somebody told him at that point in time, or something in his head told him that this is a person who will be able to do this film. But the phone call played an important role, but it wasn't that I sealed the deal on the phone. Then I met him after. And we stayed in touch. And ye Feb ki baat hai, we shot the film then in August, September. And here we are in May. 15 months later on the release. No, if I dress like this, maybe.
No. I mean, it's for me, he didn't stand out. For me, the perception that I had and the people I had met during the course of my research, and all of them, most of them, were very unlike people. People who would pass off. And for me, Arjun passed off. Arjun passed off as the character that I had written, as the people whom I had met. There was nothing that stood out for me, you know, in terms of, because at that point you are also thinking the unlikeliness of it, you know, the unlikely actor, the unlikely person, an unlikely behavior of that character. But as you go along, there are certain things that an actor and a director collaborates on. How does I see that character? And then there are something that he brings in. Then something comes from the research. Something comes from the people we meet. And then we bring everything together. And then we start collaborating it on when we are shooting. So that's how it comes together. But instinctively, while I was writing, once I finished writing it, and he's right that that phone call was important. But in that moment, it was very instinctive, and he was somebody who suited that character at that point of time.
We didn't meet the specific officers for obvious security reasons. We didn't meet them. But Raj sir got me to meet certain officials, certain officers, certain people who operate under the radar for our country. There's a certain demeanor that they have which was important that I needed to understand, the physicality of it, you know. A lot of times you imagine when you're playing an intelligence officer or you're playing somebody from the official part of the agency, you feel it's all about the brawn. But if you look at it, intelligence bureau, that is the IB, whose word mein hi intelligence is, so you need to understand the psychological build up, the psychological understanding what they have, how they conduct themselves, how they deal with pressure, how they react to situations and circumstances. So when I sat down with them, the first thing I realized is they are very, very calm. They do not conduct themselves like heroes. They look and behave and live like regular middle class 9-to-5 people, because they do not believe they are heroes. They do this for the love of the country, and they do not carry the badge of saying that, you know, wo robe nahi hai unme, they are very normal, because that's how they blend. I think it came from a fact that, you know, for a father, a child will always be a child, and that's fair, because that is the nature of a parent. But when you see your son or your daughter pulling off a role or choosing to do a role that needs sensitivity, emotional sensitivity, to have the mental foresight to do it with respect and dignity, and when you see the trailer or a teaser or a poster where you feel a sense of belonging with them, the thought is nice, but to actually see it unfold, where you see your son coming of age in a certain way and being able to play a character with a certain amount of decency, I think that's always a proud moment for a father, saying, okay, the boy is growing up and taking wise decisions, and he's playing roles that suit him, and that he's ready to take the right kind of chances and risks, because there is a risk in every film, but there is, I guess, to do a film like this, it's easy for Raj sir, after Raid, he could have gone into the commercial trappings. It's easy for me to try and influence him and put pressure and say, let's add two songs, let's add a heroine, let's be dishonest and corrupt the film slightly, just to protect it and save it from being looked at as a different film. But I feel different is important, because that is how you're able to tell a story with honesty. So I think my father saw all those trappings come through in the material. That's why he felt proud, and he thought it's a mature decision for me to do the film. I think it already has. The fact that when I read it, I realized that we take it for granted. We as the youth of today, we as the regular common man of India, are safe every day, but we do not realize, and we don't maybe pay heed to how many times our government officials, our plainclothes officers, our agencies have made sure that we can have good days. You know, we only remember them in those one or two, God forbid, bad moments. We only remember them on Independence Day and Republic Day. That is when we pay our tribute and we feel we've done our bit. It doesn't take a lot to thank those faceless and nameless people that put their lives in jeopardy every day to get to keep us safe, to catch those people that are bad, they put themselves out there, and it doesn't take a lot. Yeah. I don't know, it came to us, all of us just felt it's the right thing to do. It's a salute, it's just a thank you. And a thank you never hurt anybody. Those family members of those family, those men, those women who work for our country, they'll see it. At least they'll feel that we have gratitude in our hearts. We can't meet them personally, but so what? We keep them in our hearts.